Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss on the topic that is deadlock. Initially, we are going to discuss about its definition and examples. Deadlock is nothing but it's a set of block processes. Each of those processes holding a particular resource, and these processes are already waiting to acquire a new resource which was already being held by some another process. If we're going to talk about its second definition, then it's a set of processes are said to be deadlocked if each process in this set is waiting for an event that only another process in this set can cause. This definition will be explained by an example. For example, if we say that someone got stuck in a traffic and he or she is not being able to move his vehicle, not either in forward, backward, or in left right direction, then this condition is known as the deadlock. This is the basic example of deadlock. In the next slide, we are going to discuss about its example, which is related to operating system. Now, in the previous slide, we were talked about the word that is resource. The resource can be of many types. It can be categorized into printer, scanner, plotter, CPUs, tape drives. These are the examples of resources. Now, the another example of deadlock is when two trains are coming towards each other on the same track and there is only one track available, then none of the trains can move once in the front of each other. Now, this condition is known as the deadlock. In the similar manner, the deadlock condition has been come in operating system when there are two or more processes being held by some resource, whether it is printer, plotters, etc., and they are waiting for some other resources which are already being held by others. This example can be explained with the current situation, like in our laptops, when a user is not being able to move the mouse position, or when the keyboard key is not being responded, then the condition is known as the deadlock. Here, in this case, the circles represents as processes and rectangular box represents as resources. Here, process 1 is holding a resource 1 and waiting for resource 2. Now the resource 2 is already been acquired by another process, that is process 2, and process 2 is waiting for resource 1. This condition is known as the deadlock. The resources can be of two types. It can be preemptable, it can be non-preemptable resources. Preemptable resources are those resources which are being take off from the CPU. And non-preemptable resources are those resources which are not been able to take out from the CPU. Now, these resources have this some sequence of events. First one is request the resource. If the request cannot be immediately granted, then the process must wait until the resource is been available. For example, in the case of system calls like open malloc functions, new and request functions. The second one is use that particular resource, for example printer. The process use that a particular resource to print the file, and after that it has to release the resource. That is, the process has to release a particular resource so that it becomes available for another process. For example, close function, free, delete and release functions. Now in the next slide, we are going to discuss about some resource allocation graph. In this figure, figure A represents about the rectangular box and a circular box. Similarly, rectangular box represents resource and circular box and the circle represents process. Here, process A is holding a resource, whereas in figure B, the process B is requesting a particular resource. Now in this C diagram, if we have some circular manner, then we can say that it's a deadlock. For example, the process C is requesting a resource that is T, whereas the C is already being held by another resource that is U. Now in this manner we can say that the condition is of deadlock. Now in this next slide we are about the conditions of deadlock. There are various conditions of deadlock like mutual exclusion conditions, hold and wait conditions, no preemption condition and circular and wait conditions. These conditions we are going to discuss in our next class. Before the ending of this session, I want to tell about that what is mutual exclusion conditions. In mutual exclusion conditions, only one resource is being available at a single particular time, so that it is being available to other resources. So students, I hope you just understand my first class, and for the next class we are going to discuss about some conditions on deadlock. Thank you.